Hello guys, my name is Kiki and in this video I'm going to show you how I build this LED light panel. So let's get started. So the basic electronics for this LED panel are my LED board that I designed already roughly 1 year ago for my microscope light project, and the driver circuit board that I designed together to drive these LEDs. So you can find basically all the details about these panels at my previous video. I will put a link to this video in the description below. In that video I explained in detail how I designed the circuit boards, how the schematic looks like, how it works, and so on and so on. In this video I will not go into detail in this, I will just show you how I built this unit. So let's start with the PCB. Let's mount the LEDs. So unfortunately at the moment I only have 8 LEDs, but it's fine because I will connect 2x4 LEDs in series and I will not use the 9th LED. And the LEDs that I use are these Luxon LEDs. They are anyway 6 volt each, so connecting 4 in series will be just fine because it will be at 24 volts. Let's go for the preparation of this PCB. So what I'm going to do now is, as you can see, I put the PCB into my board holder. This way I can later on heat it from the bottom with my hot air station. And just to show you a closer look at the pins, so here you can see there is a plus. I put here a plus mark, that this means that this is the anode side of the LED, these 4 pads, and the left 4 pads are the cathode side for the LED. So I will add a little bit of solder paste on both sides and then I will reflow it from the bottom. So let's get started. Just to show you a closer look from the LED itself, as you can see, this only has two pads basically. One of them is anode, the other is the cathode, and here there is a small dot which shows that this is the anode side. So this small dot here means the anode side, so I have to put all the LEDs in this way. So let's do this. And we use solder paste, let it solder paste, a small needle, and I will try to apply a little bit of solder paste both sides. So I added a solder paste to 8 of them. I hope it's not too much. So now let's put on the LEDs and let's reflow them. Okay, now we are done. As you can see, in certain places we have a little bit of solder walls. I will clean it up now and afterwards I will check with my multimeter if I have any shorts or not. Okay, and now let's measure for shorts. No short. No short. No short. No short. Okay, so we do not have any shorts. Okay guys, so I will come now with my low power supply. I set 6 volts because each and every LED is 6 volt, and I set a current limit of 200 milliamp. So now I will check them one by one if all of them are soldered correctly. Okay, all of them are fine. Great. Okay, and that's the next step. I will connect 4 LEDs in series, and due to the reason that one LED works on 6 volt, I will have 24 volts, so I need 24 volts to operate. So I will connect these 4 in series and these 4 in series, and I will put these 2 strings parallel. Okay, so now I created little cables. I pre-tinned them to be easier to work with. And now I will connect the 3 LEDs in series. So now that we are ready with soldering, let's mark it up. Here we will have a plus, minus, and for the other one, plus, minus. Basically here we have to connect this plus to this plus, this plus, this minus to this minus, and the 2 to the board. Okay, and now this is our big plus. And this is our big minus. So I will solder up just this cable to try. Okay, and now we should be good enough for a testing. So I need to set 24 volts, and I will set something like an 800 milliamps current limit. Each LED can easily handle 600 milliamps, so it means now I have 400, even if I do not have an equal distribution between the 2 parallel lines, it should be still fine. So let's connect it up, and yes, 8 works really well, it's super bright. I think if I put a diffuser in front of it, it will work really, really well. Okay, so the next step is ready. Most probably you have to take care of the cooling also. So I will cover up with Kapton tape here. With Kapton tape here, these pads. This solder pad, and then this way I will be able to put a big heat sink or an aluminium plate onto the back of this entire board, and that will keep it cool. Okay guys, so now the PCB is wired up. As I told, these 4 are connected in series, and these 4 are connected in series, and the 2 strings are connected in parallel. It's not ideal, because basically in this case the current distribution between the 2 parallel strings is really depending on the LEDs itself, but due to the reason that I am driving them way below their ratings, I mean, with half of the ratings, it will be just fine. Even if we have a 10, 20 or 30% misbalance, it will work just fine without any problem. So, and then as I told, I will use my electronics I designed already a year ago for my microscope flight project. I just slightly modified it basically by shorting these two pins together. Previously, it was driving two LEDs. They were in series, connected in series, but no, due to reason I connected everything up here on this PCB, I only need to drive on this two wires, and this is shorted, and then this way it will just work fine. I will not go into the details of this LED driver. It's pretty simple. As I told, you can check my previous video about my microscope light project. I will put the link to this video in the description below, where I basically showed in detail how I designed and how the schematics works and so on and so on. Basically, we only have a 24 volt input, a DC input, and then we have a brightness control with this potentiometer, and that's it. There is a 5 volt regulator circuit for the op-amp operational amplifier, which is taking care of the potentiometer reading, and there is this little guy here, this little IC here, and with the belonging circuit, which is taking care of the constant current LED driving. This single resistor here is basically the current setting resistor. At the moment I'm using 160 milliohm resistor, which is setting me the current. And that's all. So what I'm going to do now, I will connect up these two cables to the LEDs. The plus goes here, minus goes here. Let me just solder it up first. Now if I connect up my DC power supply, then you can see that it suddenly works fine. This is the minimum setting. This is the maximum. It's really super bright. Okay. And then my 3D printer finished with printing. It did not turn out amazing, I will be honest with you. As you can see, there are a few gaps here and there, because I printed this with ABS and my printer is not fully enclosed. So this is not an optimal setup, but I anyway wanted to use ABS because here the temperature will go up to really high temperatures, to 60-80 degrees easily on this PCB, so ABS would be able to handle this. At the moment I will not use anything on the back of this, but later on if I see that this will reach really high temperatures, then I will just put a heatsink on each of these LEDs, or a bigger heatsink on the entire board, and that's it. I made a mistake in my 3D design, so I had to file this area here. This is where basically the two wires will go from the PCB, and then let's put the PCB into the assembly. I will just line up my cable. To sit nicely into these screwings that I just filed. Okay. And I will use 4 M3 screws for holding it together. And that's it. It's nice lean. For the moment, I will just put the electronics. I will just glue it here to the side. Later on, I will maybe print a separate box to this, but I will glue here, or I will just extend these cables. I mean, I will use a roughly 1 meter long cable, and that way I can easily put it to a higher level. I mean, put the light to a higher level, and I can put the control circuitry onto my table. So I will need to figure this out yet. It will just sit here for the moment. Yes, okay, and then to make this area here nicely reflective, I have here an aluminium tape. I ordered this previously for my repairs. It's used for chimneys and things like this. At least it was advertised, but to be honest, I tried this on PCBs while soldering, and this was melting easily on 300 degrees already, so I have no idea how would this work on a chimney which goes up to at least close to the heating. It will go up to a couple of hundred degrees maybe. Okay, so I will just use this tape and cover this all around to have a nice and reflective surface. So let's do this. Okay, so it turned out pretty nice. The camera will not really pick this up, but it's, I would say, quite okay. On the last side I had some wrinkles, but it does not really matter at the end. Okay, and then what I'm going to do, I will just use some double-sided tape for the moment, and I will put here the electronics. Have just these small rectangular double-sided tapes. Later on, I might also put some white diffusion layer here, but let's see how it works this way. So in the camera is not great. And let's see if I put here now, and let's see if it's lighting up this area better. Oh yes, definitely. It's really nice. I definitely have to fine-tune now all my settings on the camera, but I can also play with it. But it's crazy. It's crazy bright. I can also put it way to a way higher distance, and then this is still really, really good. Look at this. The camera cannot even handle this. Let's see, just as a trial, I will put a paper towel over it, just to try. I will try to cut it to slightly to size. Okay, I did not cover up the entire thing, but I will just try this. So now it should be way softer. Let's see. Yeah, I think I will do something like this. I will order from Amazon a diffusion layer. You can buy directly for this purpose white diffuser. I have no idea what is the exact name of this, but even with this one, it's way softer. Okay guys, so here it is. It's super bright. As you can see, I can light up myself with this really nicely. This is no without. Okay, now there is some light coming in from outside, but no, due to the reason that it's winter time here in Germany, it's already around 4 o'clock. It's totally dark outside, so it's really rare that I can make film, that I can make videos during the daytime. I can only do this at the weekends, but now with the help of this, I think I will be able to do really nice footage also when it's dark inside. And I can nicely change the brightness. Okay guys, so that's all for this video. I will do some testing with this and let's see how to improve it further. I hope you like this concept. If you need anything, the PCB design or the schematics or anything like this, you can find in the description below the link for my other video. And there I have everything linked, and I explain everything in detail in that video. Okay, so I hope you like this video. If yes, don't forget to like, subscribe to my channel, and I hope I see you next time. Bye!